of Geneseo included in this college ceremony. That inclusion speaks volumes about the close ties between Geneseo, the community, and Geneseo, the college. These ties have been in place so long that they are part of our culture, a facet noted even by outsiders. A case in point is this sentence that appeared in a U.S. News and World Report article on the college in Geneseo. Quote, "Walking on Main Street in Geneseo is like stepping into a vintage postcard." It is readily apparent that the author of that glowing description was not around during the summer of 2000. What we refer to as our summer of discontent. That discontent curiously coincided with the arrival of the president last year. Instead of the vintage postcard scene that perhaps helped lure Denise and Michael to Geneseo, Main Street was turned into a major construction zone, so our version of the Big Dig. Our ultimate goal was to replace an ancient leaking water main in place of the serenity, the gentle breezes wafting through trees, and the birds chirping that we had promised. They had to deal with the annoying, incessant chirping of construction equipment in reverse. Bulldozers clanging over the pavement, and dust, dust everywhere. It was clearly the antithesis of the Geneseo they had seen last December, and clearly not the picture postcard Geneseo they had every right to expect. A common expression notes that the road to wherever is paved with good intentions. In our case, the road between 15 Main Street and Doty Hall was not paved at all. Making the daily commute between home and work a true adventure in navigating the excavations, traffic cones, and construction vehicles. In spite of our good intentions of getting the paving done by late August, it was not accomplished until October. Added to that inconvenience was a mysterious water leak which flooded the Doty field for a month or so before we could locate the source, which turned out to be a few hundred feet from where it bubbled to the surface. Through it all, Denise and Michael remained calm, collected, even upbeat. But surely it had to be a stretch when they frequently responded how appreciative they were of the warm welcome they had seen at Geneseo. So, Madam President, we have nowhere to go but up. You have seen us at rock bottom. Just as we have been able to bury the problems that led to our summer of discontent by paving them over, so we'll put the rude welcome we received from Geneseo behind us. We can now concentrate on restoring the image of the community you were promised when you first visited. Geneseo has a long history of exemplary town-gown relations. The college has a vested interest in the well-being of Main Street, and what takes place on campus has a definite ripple effect throughout the community. That being said, we in the community are anxious to accompany you, to work along beside you, to collaborate as you pursue your agenda of making our institution even better in the years to come. For our part, our immediate goal is to make walking on Main Street once again like stepping into a vintage postcard. President Battles, we offer you our sincerest congratulations, best wishes, along with the hope that we will not need to repair a broken water main in front of your house for years to come. Thank you.